everybody, and welcome to Faith on Friday Extra. This series is all about highlighting people, topic, and businesses that I know you will find inspiring, interesting, and always encouraging. And I'm your host, Ricky Smith. Today's guest is really interesting because how many of you all are looking for ways to save your money? Or worse yet, have no idea where to put money? Or my favorite, you are financially illiterate. I know, it's a thing. The guest today, her name is Jaleesa Cooper. She is in the California area, but don't worry, she is licensed in a number of states, so she's gonna be able to help us with all of those questions. Hi, Jaleesa, thanks so much for joining us.
Hello, Ricky, thank you for having me. I'm super excited to meet with you today.
Oh my gosh, I am thrilled because this is a subject many of us either don't know about or had to learn it the hard way. So talk to us a little bit about what it is that you actually do.
Awesome. Yes, I can do that. So Ricky, specifically what I do in a nutshell, everyone, is I teach people about finance. So I teach people how to make it as well as how to grow it. So a lot of people, now there's a difference, and let me point out that difference. So many people, they know how to work a job. We go to school, we're told to go to school, go to work, you know, get a good job, right? So a lot of people know how to make money, but they don't know how to make it grow. Hence the wealth gap that we have, right? This huge wealth gap between the 95% and then the other 5% of the population. So in a nutshell, I teach people how to make the money and how to grow the money in a secure investment so that they can have a better financial future for them and their family.
Now see, that is already enough that you could go home on, because you are so right. So many of us were taught to grow up, go to school, get a good job, and die. No one was ever taught how to make the money and make it grow, or how to invest anything. We knew how to work. So how is it that you got into this sort of a field?
Great question. So I would honestly have to say, as a child, I've always been interested in math. So that drove me to accounting, actually. In high school, I visited a two-week camp on ISU campus, and we went over actuarial science. And I'm like, okay, I came home and I'm excited. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I love this career. I love formulas. I want to be an accountant. I want to work at a bank.
And I bet you were the sexiest kid in high school talking about, yes, I love numbers. I can't wait. I bet everybody was knocking down your door for a date.
Exactly, right? I was the nerd. Trust me. I got teased all freshman year of high school because I was that nerd. But that's why I found my love for it, for math. Just visiting that. Also, my father used to give me books all the time. He said, Jaleesa, you know what? I don't know where to invest, but I know you can't save your way to wealth. So here's a book, here's a book, here's a book. After reading these books, I soon became interested. I'm like, okay, well, how do I do this? They're talking about the 401k. They're talking about savings 101. How do I invest? How do I grow my money? So then I decided, you know what? Like, I really want to approach this career. I spoke to my older sister, who was a financial planner at the time, working for a major bank. And I'm like, hey, this is what I want to do. What do you think? And she immediately said no. She said,
wow,
banks are unethical and we just do unethical things. And she said, this is not who we are. So you will not do that career. She ended up quitting from that major bank and going back into teaching, which is something that she absolutely loves. So I took a different direction. So I actually went to school for science, food science specifically, and chemistry. But then about 3 years ago, I decided to pivot. So for me, what made me pivot was, it's a long story about my dad, but long story short, a lot of people aren't aware, but my father was terminally ill when I was in college. During this time, he was in and out of ICU for about 6 years. Doctors told us that he wasn't gonna make it. There was multiple times. And to kind of shorten this story, he had a heart transplant and he had a kidney transplant. Let's say within the last 7 to 8 years, he is alive and well now, but things weren't always peachy for us. And I have to say that in terms of health, what made the biggest difference and allowed me to pivot my career into the financial industry was about 3 years ago. I sat down with my father and I said, Dad, during this entire, my parents probably haven't worked in about 10 years. I said, during this entire time, you know, where was the money coming from? You were on your ICU bed. Mom's hair was falling out. I just wanted to stay in college. And then I didn't ask for anything else. Like, that was my only thing. Like, hey, just pay for school and I'll figure everything else out. So I asked him, and he said, you know what, Jaleesa, in my early 20s, we actually sat down with a financial professional and they helped structure my portfolio. So he had a long-term care policy, he had annuity, he had some stock investments, and literally everything that that financial professional put in place for my father, let's say 50 years ago, we need it about 10 years ago.
That's crazy, because I guess that leads to my next question. At what age do you start looking at this stuff? Because, you know, in your teens and your 20s, you're invincible. You're already going to make the most money in the world. And there's no sense in saving. Spend everything, because it's all, you know, we're all going to die type deal. So what is a good age to start something like that? And the story with your parents saying that they did it early, mm-hmm. in order to use it now, that is phenomenal. Because so many of us may find ourselves in that situation, but we're not thinking of it now. So what's a good age to get that started?
The best age is to start as soon as possible. As soon as you have that job, even if it's that first job, or you're an entrepreneur and you start your first venture, start saving, even if it's something small. Like I always tell people, even if you're saving $10 a week because you don't make enough, commit to that $10 a week and don't spend it at all. So start as early as possible. You can even start in your teenage years, because I know a lot of teenagers do work. Personally, I have a few clients that are teenagers and they are saving $100 a month. So when I personally meet someone in their 20s and they're like, Jaleesa, I can't save $100 a month, I think back and I say, okay, well, it's not, let's find out, are you not making enough money or are you spending too much? Because it's usually one of the two. Because if a 15 or a teenager can save $100 a month, right? I know they may not have all the bills and different things. Then you as an adult can at least commit to $100 a month. So that's just a number that I throw out there. I'm not saying that you have to save that amount. That's just an example. But start as early as possible. And the reason I say that is because the first rule of money is compounding interest. If you start sooner with compounding interest, your money is growing faster because you have a longer period of time that you're investing. So it's the difference between starting at like the age of 25 and 35. If you start at 25, you can invest a lower amount. Let's say you invest like $500 a month, right? You can end and finish at that 65 mark. You'd be at like $1.2 million. Now, if you start at 35, you can't invest $500 a month. You're going to be needing to invest maybe $1,000, $1,500 per month to get to that same $1.2 million at the age of 65.
My gosh. See, and again, some of the things and the terms that you're using, that goes back to my introduction talking about financial literacy. A lot of us, you know, we heard the words before, and those of us who did not absolutely love math in high school, and didn't go to school for accounting, we understand the concept of compound interest, but not really how it works for us. So when you're talking about financial literacy, what does that look like for somebody, just a regular person who I need to start saving?
So financial literacy, great question, by the way, Ricky. Financial literacy, what it means in a nutshell is understanding how to get money to work for you. So there's three simple rules of money, and I'll go through them very quickly.
Okay, before you go through them, all right, y'all, she's going to give you some information. Get a pen, y'all, because everybody doesn't know this, and y'all are getting this free information, because when you call her, you're going to have to pay her. Okay, everybody got your pens. Okay, Jaleesa, go ahead.
Okay, so financial literacy is making sure that money is working for you. So there's three simple rules of money. The first rule of money is compounding interest. This was created by Albert Einstein. He said, if you know this rule, then you are simply earning interest. If you don't know the rule, then you're paying interest. So that's the first rule of money. Now, the second rule of money is how your money can grow. So there's three different ways that your money can grow. Most people know about fixed, and most people know about variable, but many individuals are not aware that there's an indexed market. And they're like, whoa, wait, what is that? So that's the three different ways that your money can grow. Now, that rule is basically, the second rule of money is diversification. So I do all three. And based on what's happening now in the economy, I think a lot of people understand the need to be diversified, whether that's diversification in your finances or diversification in your jobs or businesses, sources of income, diversification. Now, the third and last rule of money is how money is taxed. There's three different buckets on how money is taxed. There's tax now, tax later, and tax advantage. Most people know about the tax now and the tax later because that's what they teach us. Many people outside of, you know, except the wealthy, don't know about the tax advantages because they're not taught it. So those are the three rules of money. If you'd like to know more information, we'll share it later.
Okay, that brings up a great point. You guys, don't forget, while you're here, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget, give us a thumbs up and leave a comment. And don't forget, we have all of Jaleesa's contact information in the description below, so you will be able to get in touch with her. Jaleesa, in thinking of that, when someone gets in touch with you, do you do like a discovery session or something with them, or how does that work?
Exactly. Great question. So as soon as someone reaches out to me and they say, hey, you know what, Jaleesa, I need help. I immediately get to know them first, because you have to build that relationship. I always ask people, I say, when you meet a person, is it important for them to like you or to trust you? And I get different answers from everybody.
Sure. Yeah.
The bulk of it is that they need to like you first. So they have to get to know me before they can trust me. Think about your best friend. They didn't trust you at first, right? They like you. And it's like, oh, you're really cool. Let me hang out with you. Then over time, you develop that relationship and you build that trust. So when I first meet a person, it's all about getting some face time with them. I typically, yes, we make a call to schedule the appointment or text to schedule the appointment, but I got to see you face to face, whether that's through Zoom or in person. That's completely up to you. But I sit down with them and we do a financial needs analysis. That's where we review their goals, debt, income, if they're paying rent or mortgage. We also go over some of their retirement. Like, what does retirement look like for you? So those are the things that I analyze in that first meeting, but I also educate them. So we do the education and we do the financial needs analysis in that very first meeting.
My gosh, there's so much involved in our money. And like you said, unfortunately, a lot of us were taught to work, not so much to save. And you sound like you have a lot of information, which is so great, because we want people to reach out, because everyone is looking to be rich, but very few people know how it's done. So I appreciate you taking your time to that. But Jaleesa, before I let you go, I know, me too. I love this game because it's a way for people to get to know you. Now, the game is simple. The game is called This or That. I'm just going to give you the choice between two things, and you, off the top of your head, tell me which one you like the best. Are you ready to play?
I'm ready, Ricky.
All right, here we go. All right, Android or iPhone?
Android.
Read the book or see the movie?
Read the book.
Wallflower or Life of the Party?
Life of the Party.
I can totally see that, girl. Summer fun or winter wonderland?
Summer fun.
Eat to live or live to eat?
That's hard. I would definitely say live to eat. I love food.
Yeah, me too, girl, so much. Out in nature or in the house?
Out in nature.
Okay. Coke or Pepsi?
Pepsi.
That's interesting. Okay. Drive the car or ride?
Ride.
I like sports or I don't care?
I don't care.
Okay, and finally, when you were in high school, what was your first job?
When I was in high school, actually my first job was in middle school. So high school, I worked on a farm. So I went to the Chicago High School for Agricultural Sciences. Okay. And my high school was built on the last farm in Chicago. So my first job in high school was working on a farm. So I helped in the cornfields. We helped with the pigs. I know that sounds weird for like Chicago native. Right?
And that sounds like a whole nother interview, y'all. And I promise I'm going to find out what's going on right there. Jaleesa, thank you so much for joining us. You are an absolute delight. And I appreciate your time.
Thank you, Ricky. Thank you so much. This was an honor, and I hope that I brought value to this group. I mean, you're truly amazing, and I appreciate your time today.
Thank you so much. All right, everybody, don't forget, stay tuned, because we have more interviews coming up. My name is Ricky Smith, and we'll see you next time on Extra.